Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Jacob Abraham was knifed to death on December the 7th last year. Five teenagers who tortured a 15-year-old boy to death in an alleyway behind his home can be named for the first time after they were handed life sentences today. Kai Fisher-Dixon, Shuayb Mahomud, Tremayne Gray, Omarion Stevens and Abdulqaliq Mohamed stabbed Jacob Abraham to death on December 7th last year. Hours before the fatal attack on Hurst Drive in Waltham Cross, Hertfordshire, Jacob had been helping his mom make sandwiches for homeless people. He was found dying from multiple stab wounds by his brother Isaac, who had gone out to look for him when he had not returned. Jacob was knifed 8 times in the legs and once in the arm. He died at about 10 p.m. of a wound to the right thigh which caused massive bleeding. His 5 attackers, 3 of whom were just 14 years old at the time, were captured by CCTV cameras running away from the scene. The boys, who are all from Enfield in North London, all denied murder but were found guilty by a jury after a 5-week trial at St Albans Crown Court on June 25. On Friday, they were handed life sentences by Mr Justice Edis. He said Gray and Stevens must serve at least 14 years, Mohamed 13 years and Fisher-Dixon and Mohamed 12 years. They can be named for the first time after the judge lifted anonymity orders preventing the publication of their names. Tremayne Gray, left, and Omarion Stevens, who must serve at least 14 years in prison. Abdulqaliq Mohamed, who has been jailed for at least 13 years, Kai Fisher-Dixon, left, and Shuayb Mahomud, who must both serve a minimum of 12 years behind bars. The knife attack on Jacob, who was a student at Capel Manor College in Enfield, was carried out in a service area behind his family's home. St Albans Crown Court previously heard how Jacob helped his mother prepare sandwiches for homeless people a few hours before his brutal killing. Mr Justice Edis, sentencing the boys, said, "I am sure that nobody who was involved in this attack intended to kill Jacob Abraham, but I should add to that that it seems to me what was intended was something that can properly be described as torture. By torture I don't mean a formal process of inquisition, I mean serious bodily harm which is inflicted to cause pain for a purpose. I think the intention was to leave him alive but grievously injured, in pain and humiliated." Before the jury was sent out, prosecutor Jane Bickerstaff QC said, "Jacob lived at home in Hurst Drive, Waltham Cross with his mother Sheba Abraham, his older brother Isaac and his younger sister. On the day of his death, he had attended college as normal and returned home at his usual time. At 4:39 p.m. that evening CCTV showed Jacob in the Iceland store in Waltham Cross buying bread for his mother." Ms. Bickerstaff continued, "A receipt for the bread, later found in his bedroom, confirms the time. He went home and helped his mother make sandwiches for the homeless. The family delivered those at 6:15 p.m. to a local church. Jacob then had a physio appointment at 7:39 p.m. for 15 minutes. His mother drove him and brought him back home." Ms. Bickerstaff said that in the evening Jacob received a call on his mobile phone and left the house at about 8:15 p.m. He never returned. Ms. Bickerstaff said, "He had gone to an alleyway behind the houses on Hurst Drive. He was stabbed 8 times in the legs and once through the arm. He tried to run back home, but never made it. He died in the alleyway at about 10 p.m. The prosecution cases that all 5 of these defendants were in that alleyway with Jacob at the time of the stabbing. There were at least 2 knives used. The evidence suggests that a different knife was used to attack him from the front as from behind. Although potentially only 2 of the 5 wielded a knife, all 5 are jointly responsible, having lured Jacob there and sharing the joint intention that he should suffer at least really serious harm. 5 teenagers, who cannot be named for legal reasons, have been found guilty of his murder shortly before his murder. Jacob helped his mother make sandwiches for the homeless." Ms. Bickerstaff told the jury the stabbing was not an accident and that Jacob had been lured to the area by one of the youths, who contacted the 4 others to get them into the alley at the right time. She said they had been waiting out of sight nearby until they were summoned. Ms. Bickerstaff said, "CCTV shows all 5 defendants walking in single file in the direction of the alleyway. A couple of minutes later the group are seen by witnesses in court on CCTV running away. A different CCTV camera from a block overlooking the alley also captures Jacob running, but clearly injured. He was running in the opposite direction to the way the group had gone. He left a trail of blood. His brother, worried about his absence for so long, went to look for him. Isaac Abraham found Jacob lying flat in the alleyway covered in blood. Isaac made a 999 call at 9:29 p.m. Police and paramedics arrived, but Jacob could not be saved and was pronounced dead at 10:15 p.m. A post-mortem examination showed there were multiple stable wounds, but the one that caused his death was a wound to the right thigh, which pierced both the femoral artery and the femoral vein. The prosecutor told the jury this caused massive bleeding and rapid collapse. She said Jacob's mobile phone must have been taken by the defendants. It was switched off after the attack and has not been seen since. Ms. Bickerstaff said the evidence suggested Jacob Abraham was no angel. He was a devoted son and brother, but friends and acquaintances suggest he smoked and dealt in cannabis on a fairly small scale. She said he had sometimes been involved in fights, and a few months before his death he had an argument with members of a gang known as Albany Park or AP. On his Snapchat account he had posted a message a short time before his death saying, "If you want to mess with me, come and mess with me around my yard." He posted a video of himself and a friend smoking something in the alleyway where he died. At 5:20 p.m. that evening, all five defendants were seen boarding the 279 bus at Turkey Street in North London. 2 hours later they were in Ponder's End where, at 7:40 p.m., they took a train to Waltham Cross. Broxbourne Chief Inspector Ian Butler said, "I am grateful to the Major Crime Unit for all their hard work on this case, which has allowed the jury to reach their outcome. I am sure that the community's thoughts remain with the families of all those affected. Monday's verdict must remind us all of the tragic consequences of knife crime, and that we must continue to work together as a community to prevent this becoming an acceptable culture among some of our young people."